Hi friends, today I am going to talk to you all about an entity called basal metabolic rate or BMR. So what is basal metabolic rate? Basal metabolic rate is nothing but the amount of calorie or energy spent when you are at rest. In simple terms, when you are just lying down in bed, you still burn some amount of calories. You just burn these calories in order to perform normal activities like breathing, your blood circulation, maintaining temperature and various other stuffs. So can one increase the amount of energy which is being utilized when you are at rest? Yes, you can do it. So here I am going to highlight a few things which can increase your basal metabolic rate and indirectly help you in losing more weight more efficiently. So the first thing in this is you have to perform some form of high intensity interval training. So what is it? Basically, you do any form of exercise very rapidly to the maximum potential you can for a period of 30 seconds to 1 minute, followed by a gradual slowdown for a period of 1 to 2 minutes. And again, you repeat the same high intensity workout. So this you will have to do for a span of 20 to 30 minutes. In simple terms, imagine a dog is chasing you and you are running for your life. That is an example of a high intensity interval training. Because once you escape from the dog and you start to take some rest somewhere, you will still be panting, and the amount of energy which is used even when you are at rest is quite high compared to your normal self. So this is the same technique which is used in high intensity interval training as well. So other than this workout, is there any other options? And workout, when I mean, is it only jogging? No, you can even do cycling, you can play any sports where you do a fast sprint, then take rest for some time and again get back to your fast sprint. Or you can walk very briskly for a speed which you think is the maximum you can do for a minute and then take rest for a couple of minutes, or walk slowly for a couple of minutes, again increase the speed. So you do this in cycles for a period of 20 to 30 minutes. And this is very good to increase your basal metabolic rate, because even after you stop the exercise and come back home and take rest, still your body will be recovering from that intensity and it will use a lot more energy than normally required. So this is one common way of doing it. In other than this, what are the other ways you can do it? For youngsters and people who are moderately mobile, you can start doing some form of weightlifting, as all this weightlifting will help in building up more of muscles. We clearly know that muscles burn more energy and calorie compared to fat. To be precise, nearly 6 to 8 times of more calorie is burnt by a muscle when compared to fat. So you don't have to become a bodybuilder in order to build muscles, but carrying just basic weights will help you in achieving this goal and indirectly increase your basal metabolic rate as well. So other than this building muscles by lifting weights, what are the other options? You can start taking a high protein diet. Most of you would heard or read at some other place saying that you should take a high protein diet. See, a high protein diet is not only essential to have a healthy diet, it indirectly also improves your basal metabolic rate. Because the amount of energy which is required to break down a protein is much more when compared to a fat. So indirectly, when you take a high protein diet, which means your body has to go through a process to break down the protein, which will consume more energy and indirectly help you to burn more calories and lose weight. So this is the third way by which you can increase your basal metabolic rate. So other than this, there are still some other ways by which you can increase your basal metabolic rate. One is consuming natural food or normal food. What do you mean by natural food or normal food? See, generally when you take a food and you consume it, your body is accustomed to various steps of digestion. For example, if you put something in your mouth, then your salivary amylase acts, which in turn triggers a whole cascade of enzymes which are required for digestion and the whole process of digestion, so which will happen in steps. Whereas if you consume some form of food with preservatives, they are already broken down into simple form of food. So the whole process of digestion is bypassed. So your body is not accustomed to it. And the second thing, when you take food which are broken down like that, the amount of energy which is utilized to have a food broken down into simple products or have a proper digestion is not there. So you are not in breaking down more calories, or you are not burning more energy. Rather, you are consuming a lot of energy which is totally not utilized for this purpose. So this again is another way of having a good amount of diet, as well as helping you to increase your basal metabolic rate indirectly. You can take plenty of water, because hydration is very important. If one is dehydrated, that will indirectly decrease your BMR, and it can help in a lot of issues which can be solved by just consuming a lot of plenty of water. So other than consuming plenty of water, what are the other options we have? One should definitely not have too much stress, and they should have an adequate amount of sleep. We all know that everyone advises us to have a sleep. Sleep has to be taken at a proper time as well. You can't work a night shift and sleep in the morning and say you are sleeping adequately for 6 to 8 hours, which means you are totally normal. No, it is not so. Our human body has something called as a circadian rhythm, which essentially works functioning thinking that we will work in the day and sleep in the night, and it is tuned for that. When we break down this, a lot of complex things happen, and we know that we do not feel healthy or we are not active, but you don't know what the exact reason for the same is. So in order to avoid this, one should have a good amount of sleep. And when you are very stressful, your basal metabolic rate automatically decreases, because your body thinks you are getting ready for some form of a fight. So it's like a trigger mechanism where it tries to conserve all the energy for that stressful activity. But it doesn't understand that stress is just a thought process. So when you are calm and rested, your basal metabolic rate is definitely much more than a stressful person. So being calm also is very important. There was a study sometime earlier which said green tea can improve your basal metabolic rate by up to 4%. Even though there are certain fallacies in the study, but right now we still have some evidence to say even green tea might help you in increasing the basal metabolic rate slightly. But you can understand the things which I told you in the first are the most important, and the things which I told you in the last are probably having very minimal effect on your basal metabolic rate. So I hope you would have some clarity regarding the basal metabolic rate, and it will guide you in your quest to lose some weight and have a healthy lifestyle. Thank you very much. If you have any more doubts, you can contact me at Ashwin Hospital. Thank you.